definition of what love is. It helps to know three things in order to understand love. You have to understand what love is, what the opposite of love is, and what is in between. The most simple definition of what love is self-giving. And then the opposite of love is using others. So the opposite of loving is using. The opposite of love, I've heard a lot of people say that it's hate, but hate just falls under the category of envy. It's a form of envy. It's not really the opposite of love. And I've heard some people say that indifference is the opposite of love. But indifference is really to not do anything at all. It's neither hot nor cold. It's kind of like a gray area that's in between loving and using. Love is an act of the will. And then the opposite of love, using, is also an act of the will. It's something that you do. Love is something that you do. It's an act. I think a lot of people, they confuse loving and using with one another. And when you get into a relationship, they love what they get from the other versus self-giving. They love what they get from the other, but love is what you give. A good example of love is a child. A child, you give of yourself. You give your flesh and your blood to your child. You give the works of your hands to your child. You give your time, your emotions, your intellect, everything that you are, you give to your child. So a child is the love between a husband and a wife. It is the self-giving between a husband and a wife. It's the common union between a husband and a wife. It's the self-giving and common unity. Common unity is where we get the word community, and that's actually where communities come from. But another thing that helps is, for example, if a man has sex with a woman and then leaves, that means that he's used that woman. So that's why it's important to be married before you have sex, because it's an act of using the person. Because if you're not married, that means that you're planning on leaving. And if you're not planning on leaving, then you would be married. So marriage is important to love. And if you go to the opposite extreme, if a man and woman were married for a long time and then they split, that means that the entire time that they were married, it turns the act they're willing to sacrifice for the other, that just makes the love between them so much stronger. And, you know, as they grow older together with each other, you know, all the sacrifice between them, you know, during their whole lives, that is the very thing that, like, makes the love between them so much stronger. So that self-giving is the greatest thing. You know, the love is the greatest thing. That willingness to sacrifice for the other is the greatest thing in the relationship. But there's, like, a lot of divorces nowadays, and I think a lot of people confuse using and loving, and, you know, they love what they get from the other, but whenever sacrifice comes along, you know, they split because of it, because they're unwilling to sacrifice for the other whenever problems come along. But the people who are willing to sacrifice and go through all these trials together with one another, they're the ones who have the greatest love. So I hope this video helps people understand what love is, and that's all for now.